स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर डिस्कशन इन अप्लाइड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। वी हैव सीन सम थ्योरी पार्ट इन रेफ्रिजरेशन। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दैट मॉड्यूल 4, साइकोमेट्री। साइकोमेट्री डील्स विद स्टडी ऑफ एयर, स्टडी ऑफ मॉइस्चर इन एयर। सो दिस मॉइस्चर विच इज अवेलेबल इन एयर maybe from 1 to 3, around 4%, but this moisture plays a very vital role in comfort air conditioning as well as for process parameters in chemical industry, textile industry, etc. So we will study the various terms which we come across in psychometry, like define specific humidity, degree of saturation, relative humidity, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, saturated and unsaturated air. Specific humidity is defined as the mass of water vapor to the mass of dry air in a given volume of mixture, and the formula is, this is omega. Omega is equal to 0.622 PV. This is partial pressure of water vapor divided by P minus PV, where P is the total pressure of the air and omega is the specific humidity and PV is the partial pressure of water vapor. So this is a very standard equation which you will be using. Omega is equal to 0.622 PV divided by P minus PV, where P is the total pressure, that is P is equal to PA plus PV, means PA stands for partial pressure of dry air plus PV stands for partial pressure of vapor, water vapor. So this units of specific humidity is kg of water vapor per kg of dry air. Now comes degree of saturation. It is the ratio of actual specific humidity to the specific humidity of saturated air, both at the same temperature. See, I'll tell you one thing. The amount of water vapor that the air can hold depends on the temperature. Please understand, the lower the temperature of air, the lower the amount of water it can hold, and the higher the temperature, the higher the amount of water it can hold. I told you it can go from 0 grams to almost 40 grams depending on the temperature. Okay. But in psychometry, normally we study up to like 40-45 degrees centigrade only, because the ambient temperature will be that much only. Okay. So I'll repeat, degree of saturation means what is the amount of water vapor to the maximum amount of water vapor it can hold. So it is the ratio of actual specific humidity to the specific humidity of the saturated air, both at the same temperature. Temperature is very important, because if the temperature changes, the capacity of the air to hold water changes. Next, relative humidity. It is the mass of water vapor to the mass of saturated water vapor in the same volume and at the same temperature. Relative humidity means, again, this means relative humidity. Relative means related to the saturated. What is the actual mass of water vapor to the mass of saturated water vapor at the same volume and at the same temperature. Then comes dry bulb temperature. We measure temperature with thermometer. If the bulb of the thermometer is dry, we call it as dry bulb temperature. It is the actual temperature of the moist air measured by an ordinary thermometer. Next is wet bulb temperature. You have not seen wet bulb temperature. So wet bulb is same dry bulb temperature only, thermometer only will be taken, but to the bulb where the mercury is there, we will tie a cotton wick and submerge that wick in water and saturate it with water, and then we will rotate it, and then whatever temperature we get, that is known as wet bulb temperature. It is the temperature of moist air measured by the thermometer whose bulb is covered with a wet cloth, and always the wet bulb will be less than the dry bulb temperature for unsaturated air. But if the air is fully saturated with air,